Hello students, welcome back to channel. Students, we already completed 15.1 practice set of area, and it is based on the parallelogram, and we have written all the formulas. You need to learn the formula by heart. And again on page number 96, one more topic, one more new formula is there, that is area of a rhombus. Okay, so area of rhombus, we need to understand it, and what exactly it is given here. One formula is there. Okay, so let's write important point, what exactly the rhombus is there. Okay, so let's start our new video today. If you're new to the channel, please subscribe the channel, and if you really like the video, please press the like button. Okay, so let's start. What is a rhombus? So rhombus is, first we need to draw the figure. Okay, so we draw the figure here first of all. Okay, it looks like a diamond something. Okay, like this. It is look like a diamond similar to. Now what is rhombus? We'll write the one by one. A rhombus is a, we can write rhombus is a four equal sides. Okay, we can give the name also, A, B, C, and D. And diagonals of rhombus making a right angle triangle perpendicular to each other. So rhombus is the four sides quadrilateral. Is the four equal sides quadrilateral. All sides are equal. Rhombus is a special type of parallelogram. Okay. Now the second point is, see, rhombus is look like a diamond. So we can write also a rhombus. Looks like a diamond. Okay, for need to understand how it looks like, it looks like a diamond. Okay, now third point is, see, opposite sides of rhombus are parallel and opposite angles are also equal. Okay, so we need to write here opposite sides are parallel and opposite angles are equal. Okay, now the fourth point is the height is a distance and making a right angle triangle of the two sides, one and two sides making a right angle triangle. So we can also write the altitude or the height. The altitude is the distance at a right angle triangle, because it is perpendicular, so it is making a right angles to two sides. Okay, we can write here to two sides. Okay, now very important, what exactly the area of rhombus? So area of rhombus, we can write the formula here. Area of rhombus is equal to half into a product. Product means multiplication. Product of lengths of the diagonal. Diagonal here, AC and BD are the diagonals. So lengths of diagonal. Okay, now one more formula is there of rhombus, that is perimeter of rhombus. Perimeter, student, as perimeter is nothing but sum of all sides of a figure. So how many sides of a figure have? Four sides, okay? Because it is a quadrilateral, the four sides. So four into side is the perimeter of rhombus formula. And area of rhombus is half into product of length of the diagonal. Okay? Understood? Okay, now let's start 15.2 practice set. I already written the questions. It is there on the in the textbook also. So on the page number 97, four questions are there. Okay, so we'll take one by one. It's very simple, just we need to learn the formula by heart. Okay, so let's start. Length of a diagonal of a rhombus are 15 centimeter and 24 centimeter. Find its areas. Very simple. Okay, just write area of a rhombus. Area of rhombus. So what is the formula? Half into product of the diagonal, or you can write length of product of diagonal. Okay, simply you can write product of diagonals also. So 1 upon 2 into, now product of diagonals is already given in the question. You know the length of diagonal of rhombus are 15 and 24. You just, you need to write 15 and 24 here. Okay, now just do a simple simplification here. So here 2 ones are 2 and 2 twos are 4. Okay, so 1 into 15 is 15 into this is 12. So if you multiply, it's 15 tens of 15, 15 twos are 30. So 150 plus 30 is 180. So the answer is 180. So we are finding the area, so we need to write here centimeter square. Okay, just do the rough work. We can do the rough work also, that is not a great deal. 2 5 is a 10, 1 carry, 2 1 is a 2 plus 1 3. One more value is there, 1 5 is a 5 and 1 1 is a 1. So it is 180. So the answer is 180 centimeter square. Okay, got it everyone? So this is the first answer of practice set 5.2. I hope you understood. Okay, now let's go to the second question now. Now second question is, again the length of the diagonal of a rhombus is given. Now here the decimal value is given now, 16.5 centimeter and 14.2 centimeter, find its area. The same, directly we can write here area of rhombus. Area of rhombus. Formula same, half into length of product of diagonals. Okay, so we can write lengths of product of diagonals. You can directly write product of diagonals also. Okay, so 1 upon 2, it is in the formula. And what are the two lengths are here? 16.5 multiplied by 14.2. Okay, 16.5, we cannot divide it by 2, so we can divide this. 2 7s are 14 and 2 1s are 2, and this is the decimal is there. So 1 into 16.5 is 16.5 multiplied by, this is 7.1 here. Okay, and if we multiply it, you know, see here, after one digit decimal here, after one digit decimal, you can simply write 165 into 71. So our answer is, you can directly write, we can do the rough work also. 165 into 71. 1 5 is a 5, 1 6 is a 6, 1 1 is a 1, 7 5 is a 35, 3 carry, 7 6 is a 42, 45, 4 carry, 7 is a 7, and this is 11. So this is 5 1 7 1 1. Okay, so the answer is 1 1 7 1 5. Now see, after, this is one digit after decimal and this is one digit after decimal. It means total two digit we need to put the answer after the decimal. So 1 and 2, the decimal we need to put here. Okay, so the answer is 117.15 centimeter square. Okay, so it's very simple. You need to do the rough work also while taking out the correct answer. Okay, now let's go ahead with the next one now. Now the next question is, now here the perimeter of a rhombus is given. So we already learned the formula. Perimeter is nothing but 4 into side. Okay, so the perimeter of a rhombus is 100 centimeter and length of one diagonal is 48 centimeter. What is the area of the quadrilateral? Okay, so we need to first put perimeter of rhombus. So we'll get the side, and after side we can take out the formula also. Okay, so perimeter, just we need to write here perimeter of rhombus is given 100 centimeter. Okay, now perimeter of rhombus, we know that 4 into side, okay, is equal to 100. So we need to take out the side. So side we need to take it out here and we need to write 100, and in between the side 4 is there, so 4 will go into the denominator, just divide it. So side is equal to 4 2 is 8 and 2 remains, so it is 20, and this is 4 5 is 20. So this is 25 centimeter. Okay, we can draw the figure also, you can for your illustration. we can draw the figure also here. Okay, so this is one diagonal and this is the another diagonal. We can give the name also. So this is A, B, C and D. This is 90 degree. Okay, now side we got it 25. So 25 side we got it. Okay, already. Now in question, one diagonal is 48. So this is, suppose AC is 48. We need to take out the length of area of the quadrilateral. So just we can write here each side of rhombus is, each side of rhombus, we got it 25 because sides are equal here, 25 centimeter. Now diagonals of a rhombus is bisect each other at 90 degree, hai na? Ye 90 degree pe it is bisecting here. So we need to write here diagonals of a rhombus bisect each other at 90 degree. So therefore suppose this is O. Okay, so we need to find here AO is equal to OC. Okay, so AO is equal to OC is equal to, you know, we need to half it. So 48 divided by 2 here. So 48 divided by 2 is 24 centimeter. Okay, so this is our final answer. Okay, of the question number third here. We need to take out the value. We'll check it out. We need to take out the area of the quadrilateral also. Okay, so area of the rhombus also we need to find it out. Okay, so we got it here 24. So we got it here 24 here. Okay, and this is 25. This is also 25. This is also 25. And this is also 25. Now what we have to do is, in triangle, suppose in triangle AOB, see here, in triangle AOB, angle O is 90 degree here. So we need to write here angle O is 90 degree. So whenever a triangle, right angle triangle is there, so we need to apply here by Pythagoras theorem. Now what the Pythagoras theorem says, that hypotenuse square is equal to side 1 square plus side 2 square. So AB square is equal to AO square plus OB square. Okay, so AB is 25 square. So 25 ka square. AO, we need to, AO is also there, 24. Okay, it is half is there. So 24 ka square. And OB, we need to find it out. So 25 ka square, we know that 625, and 24 ka 576 plus OB square. So take out OB here. So OB square is equal to, we need to subtract it, both this value, 625 and plus 76 becomes minus 576. Okay, so 625 minus 576 is 49. So we need to write here OB square is equal to 49. This square becomes, you know, under root 49. So OB is equal to 49 square root is 7. Okay, so OB is 7 centimeter. Okay, so we got it, OB is 7 centimeter. Now what is the value of DB? 7 into 2. You know, what is the value of DB here? 7 into 2. So we can write DB is equal to 2 into OB. Okay, because it is double of that. OB we got it 7, so this is also 7, and 7 plus 7 is 14, so it is double of OB, and OB we got it 7, so 2 7s are 14. Now we got it DB here 14. Okay, now we can put the area of rhombus, that is area of quadrilateral. Area of rhombus, we know the formula is equal to half into product of diagonals. Okay, half into product of diagonals. Okay, so what is product of diagonals? 1 upon 2 into product of diagonals, one we got 14 and the another we got it 48. Okay, 14 and 48. 14 and 48. Okay. So 2 sevens are 14. So 1 into 7 is 7 into 48. Okay. So the answer is 7 8 is 56. 7 4 is 28 plus 6 is 33. So the answer is 336 centimeter square. So this is the answer of the third question. Okay. A little bit a lengthier one, but it's very simple and very easy. Okay. I hope you understood this question also. Now let's take the last one now. Now the last question is also look like same only of the third question. The length of the diagonal of a rhombus is 30 centimeter and its area is 240 square centimeter. Find its perimeter. Now if you draw the figure here, okay, let's draw the figure for our understanding purpose. We can give the name, same name, ABCD will give. Okay, this is the right angle triangle and length of the diagonal is 30. Suppose AC is 30 and its area is 240. Find its perimeter, means all the sides we need to find it out. Now diagonal, length of the diagonal of a rhombus is only one is given. So another length of the diagonal we need to assume as a D. So we can write here, let the diagonals, let the diagonal be D centimeter. Okay, this diagonal we don't have. We can either write DB also, okay, as a diagonal. Now area of rhombus. So area of rhombus, we know the formula, half into product of diagonals. Okay, product of diagonals. Okay, product of diagonals. Now put the value here. Area of a rhombus is already given, 240. Okay, so we need to write here 240 is equal to 1 upon 2 into, okay, product of diagonals. We have here 30 and the other diagonal we have assumed here D only. Okay, so we can divide it 2 into 15. Okay, so what is remaining, 240 is equal to 1 into 15 is 15 into D. So let's take out the D here. So D is equal to, we need to write 240 and whatever the value is there with the D will go into the denominator. Okay, so therefore D is equal to 15 ones are 15 and 9 remains, so it is 90. So 15 6 za. Okay, 90. We can make a division also, a little rough work. Okay, 15 ones are 15, it is 9 remaining. We can pull down this 0 here. So 15 6 are 90. Okay, so our D is 90 here. Now see here, we got 19 D here, 16. Okay, so AC is 30 and DB is 16 centimeter. So we can write here, AC is 30 centimeter and DB is 16 centimeter. That is the other diagonal. Now we know that the diagonal of a rhombus bisect, okay, at right angles. So we can write here, diagonals of a rhombus, diagonal of a rhombus bisect at right angles, bisect at right angles. Okay, so we can give this O in triangle AOB, in triangle AOB. Okay, angle O equal to 90 degree. So let's take out the formula AB square. First we need to take the hypotenuse. So AB square is equal to AO plus OB. So AO square plus OB square here. Now put the formula, put the value here. AB we need to find it out. Okay, AO is 15 square and OB we got it OB, we got it, half of 16 is 8. So we need to write here 8 square. So 15 ka square 225 and plus 8 ka square is 64. Okay, both this we need to take the half. So this is 289. This is AB square and again this is AB square. So therefore AB is equal to square, we can shift. So it becomes under root 289. So AB is square root of 89 is 17 centimeter. Okay, square of 17 is 289. So square root of 289 is 17 centimeter. Okay, now what we need to find it here? Perimeter. So we need to write here perimeter is equal to, what is the formula perimeter? 4 into side. So 4 into side, we got it. How much? It is 17. So we write here 17. So 17, 4 is 68. So this is 68 centimeter. Okay. So this is the last question of our second practice set. I hope you understood. Okay. If you really like the video, please thumbs up the video also. Okay. And take care of yourself. Complete your notes. Okay. So thank you very much. Thanks for watching.